Welcome back guys, this is Shuman Bhattacharjee on behalf of Shomus Biology and we are talking about how to crack CSIR NET. How to crack, right? So it's kind of difficult for you if you think that it's kind of complicated. Though it's complicated, but you can crack it because we have discussed it before. We have talked about the different schematics of the experiment of this exam. Now we are going to talk about group A and individually how to crack group A first, because remember you need to crack group A, otherwise they won't check your copy of group B and C. Now remember, group A consists of 15. You need to answer 15 questions, each carries 2 marks, total marks of 30, but 20 questions are provided. So you need to answer, if you can successfully answer 8 questions out of 20, then you are doing a good job and you will crack through CSIR NET, right? So you need to answer 8 questions correctly out of 20 questions. That's very, very important, guys. At least 8. If you can do this, more than 8 is good, but at least 8. Now in this case, for group A, they usually check your IQ. So if you're having an IQ level, you can't develop it on your own like that. So you need to have an IQ to answer most of the questions. Some questions, 3 or 4 questions, you can easily answer because it depends on your common sense. You can easily answer those questions using your common sense. But except for that, they will ask you some numerical problems because they will check your quantitative aptitude that you are having, and also they will check. So they will check for your quantitative aptitude, which is also called general aptitude, and also they will check numerical reasoning. They will check numerical reasoning, right? So these are the things they will check for in group A, and they are going to ask many questions regarding geometry. So that's the topic that you need to follow. You need to follow geometry very, very well, and especially geometry of 3-dimension objects like a cylinder, like a spherical ball, like a cube, and like a chong. So you need to follow the formulas. You need to know the formulas of surface area. You need to know the formulas of volume. So most of the problem they are going to give you is surface area volume problems they are going to provide you. So you need to know those 3D object surface area and volumes. You probably forget, you are a biology student, you don't having any practice for geometry and maths. So that's kind of difficult for people to get through CSIR at group 1 or group A. But if you practice it, if you watch those formulas once or twice, those formulas are easier, guys. You can easily remember them and you can apply them when required. Now other things that you require is they are going to ask you questions regarding trains, so problems regarding trains. So train problems will be there. Train problems will be there, and train problems regarding trains are moving at opposite directions, what you need to do when the trains are going in the same directions, and what we will do when the trains are going parallelly and differently. And so different types of combinations are there. So you need to solve train problems. You need to solve, you need to solve profit and loss problems. Profit loss problems, those are very important problems. You need to solve height and distance problems, which is a part of trigonometry. Height and distance problems. Then you need to solve. I've found that in previous 2 or 3 times, CSIR NET are going to give you more questions from this height and distance. At least 1 question from height and distance, and they are kind of giving you kind of 3 or 4 geometrical questions. So it's very, very important to stick to this geometry and height and distance, which is a part of trigonometry, to have a clear understanding of the formulas and how to solve them, right? So, and also you need to solve questions regarding simple interest, in bank interest. You need to have an understanding of age and relation. Problem regarding age and relation, that's also very, very important to understand for CSIR NET. And previous year they provide a question of age and relation. And also you need to know about number series, number or alphabet series problems, and also picture series problems. And these problems are given to test your reasoning. Series is like different, say number 2, 5, 8, what is going to be the fourth one? So answer is 11, because if you follow the series, it is increasing plus 3 by every time. So after increasing it, ultimately it will be 11. So that's the type of problem from number series they are going to give you. They are going to give you problems regarding alphabet series. So you need to follow the pattern in the series and then give the answers. And also picture series are very important to test your reasoning and ability to get and analyze something. So it's very, very important. Analyzing things are very important there. You need, they will provide you problems regarding percentage values. They will give you problems regarding probability. That's a very, very important thing. Probability is an important thing here. So they can ask for probability there, right? And so not hardcore math, as you are seeing. The math is very basic. Math of 6th, 7th, 8th standard math. So you need to have a kind of practice of those formulas. You need you kind of forgot those formulas. So just practice it once or twice so that the formulas are kind of easy for you. Then go for solving problems and you can get this answer. If you wondering that from where you're getting the formulas because you don't have the books anymore, don't worry, Shomus Biology is always here. You can go for my website or my channel, whatever. You go to my YouTube channel, you will find a complete playlist of videos. It is telling the general aptitude and reasoning. Go to that playlist, you kind of find 56 to 60 videos on reasoning and aptitude, specially made for CSI and NET and GATE exams. So you can go with that. I am having different sections, whatever I discussed here, geometry to profit loss and all these problems that I've enlisted. I take each of these problems and I made videos about 10 to 12, 13 videos about each of them, combining the formulas in one video. So you can just look for formulas if you want. So videos are there for formulas as well as there are videos for solving different questions and answers regarding these different topics. So it's your choice. You can go there, you can learn there whenever, whatever you can from there. So build your concept, learn mathematics there because it is required to solve group A and you need to pass group A to go to other qualifying rounds. So that's why it's very important, guys. Stick to the basics. Again, it is possible. 8 out of 20 questions, it is kind of possible. And if you are having mild common sense, if you are having your normal IQ, you will be able to get through group A. It's not a big deal, guys. And I always tell students that you should not take more than 30 to 40 minutes to solve or 45 minutes to solve this. If you take more than that, it will be difficult for you to solve the other groups like group C and group B because you need to give more time to group C than group A and B. So that's kind of it, guys. It's easier. Go to my website, go to my channel and view the general aptitude and reasoning playlist. You will find everything in detail. That's it. Thank you.